A well-known Colorado real estate investor is suing one of the largest banks in the nation for discrimination.
Christopher Narin says she was profiled at a branch in Denver because of her race, resulting in the manager calling the police on her, even putting employees in a safe. The bank adamantly disputes these claims. FOX31 problem solver Nicole Fierro has a story.
Whether you're breaking into the Denver housing market or commuting down Colorado.
I do have billboards up in Colorado. I am a broker and investor here in Denver, and I have been for such a long time, since 08.
Christopher Narin is a familiar face to many in the metro, but real estate isn't why she's sitting down with the FOX31 problem solvers.
I feel like the story is just, it's not anything that I anticipated.
This story starts 5 miles down the same road as this billboard, at this Colorado Boulevard Chase Bank branch.
I did bank with Chase for a while, for over a decade.
And now things have changed.
It has come to an abrupt end.
Narin takes us back to November 2021, the date of this Denver police report, the incident prompting this case first filed in Colorado's district court and now moved over to federal court.
I never thought I would leave that branch in fear. And I did.
A typical stop for Narin, a Chase drive-thru before a client meeting.
At that time, I just deposited funds that I was using to purchase another property.
The $80,000 deposit taking a bit longer than what she's experienced before with this kind of cash.
Then it was 20 minutes. So I rang the bell and pressed the button, and the woman came on and I said, hey, you know, I'm just checking on my deposit. What seems to be the holdup?
Narin says the bank manager's response in the drive-thru.
But it wasn't just like a normal response, it was a quip.
Drove her to head inside to try to figure out what was happening.
And she's like, you're rude and disrespectful. And at this time, it's been 20 minutes. You know, I'm over my window. I need to make it to Thornton. And I said, you know what? I'm like, you're actually rude. Go ahead and give me my funds from the branch and, you know, I'll bank elsewhere. But, you know, I banked there for 10 years without issue until this event. So then she called 911. I heard her on the 911 call. And then she pushed all of her employees into the safe. And so I thought to myself, this is now a very dangerous situation that she created.
And you did nothing that you felt warranted any putting anyone in a safe or having anyone feel like their safety was in jeopardy.
You are behind 8 inches of plexiglass, and all I have is my purse, and I'm making a deposit. I have no weapon on me. I thought, what is this woman doing?
According to the Denver Police Incident Report, the caller claimed a customer was threatening staff with no weapons seen, saying they don't know who they're messing with and will light the place up. Words Narin says never came out of her mouth. Problem solvers requested body camera of the police response, but DPD says it doesn't exist. The report shows a request to cancel before police arrived.
If you were truly in fear of your safety and the safety of your employees, you would have pressed charges.
Narin's now taking legal action, with Chase's latest response in the courts, a motion to dismiss, saying in part, Narin simply alleges her check deposits took too long and that she was African American. Everything else is an assumption that cannot save the complaint. Chase goes on to claim Narin was not satisfied with her service and assumed it was because of her race. But the next turn of events after that interaction in person is what Narin's lawsuit surrounds. Narin says she immediately called customer service after the event, aiming to speak to corporate about what happened and her funds in that account. Narin received this letter dated on December 2nd, but ending up in her mailbox, she says, on or around December 4th. It states her accounts were closed due to inappropriate conduct with our employees. It gives a timeline of mailing a check with the rest of her funds within 10 business days.
I have earnest money that's in jeopardy. I have earnest money on the line. I'm under contract on a property that I'm under market value on. Like, this deal is extremely important to me.
A deal she ended up missing out on because she couldn't get the money in time to close. What she says she voiced over and over again before that date.
So our focus is more on the contract. So we have a breach of contract case. Everybody who opens an account at Chase basically agrees to the terms of a deposit account agreement.
Chase's motion to dismiss states even if Chase closed Narin's account in response to her customer service complaint, it is permissible under the DAA, the agreement she and others sign when they open an account. It says Chase has a contractual right to end its relationship with a customer, and Narin not only agreed Chase could do exactly what she alleges Chase did, but also requested it. It also says her final claim for torturous interference rests on the frivolous assertion that Chase both knew she needed her account open to close on a home purchase and close the account at her request to disrupt the deal. Chase claims her case lacks evidence showing the effort Narin put in to inform Chase of the real estate deal. Two different views of a lost deal due to what Narin sees as banking while black, what she hopes this lawsuit can prevent for another customer.
Equity and inclusion really matters, and it matters in this day and age in 2024. And that's all we're looking for.
In Denver, Nicole Fierro, Fox 31.
To be clear, we reached out to Chase Bank for a statement and to request footage from the event. The bank responded in part in saying, and I quote, "We do not tolerate discrimination of any kind. We also take seriously the safety of our employees, especially when they feel abused and threatened in the branch. In this case, we dispute the factual allegations. As for the case itself, both sides are now waiting for a judge to rule on whether it'll be dismissed or continue in court. We'll keep you updated."